Hello, and welcome to Dissident Theory. Thanks for checking out this video series on a bite-sized approach to understanding Marx's three volumes of Capital. In this first short video, I'll be briefly discussing my intentions for doing this series, my personal approach for reading Marx, and some general disclaimers about the books themselves. If this doesn't interest you and you'd prefer to just get stuck in with the reading, then feel free to skip to the next video. However, I do advise that maybe you do watch it, purely because I will discuss ways in which the books develop the narrative of their arguments and some of the context which they were written under, which might help you understand them a little more clearly. First up, why am I doing this? Well, with anti-capitalist struggles coming to the forefront of discussion again in recent years, especially in online spaces, I often see people discussing or arguing about capitalism or how it functions and its ramifications on the world around us. I don't want to discourage those conversations or even disprove them. In fact, I think it's very important that we have new ideas and new conversations about capitalism and the anti-capitalist struggle. I notice many people online like to mention Marx and his ideas, whether in brief comments or memes, but quite often say that they would like to read Capital, but don't have the time available or patience. And that's completely understandable. This series is aimed at providing a brief overview of Capital, chapter by chapter, to help people form at least some understanding of Marx's arguments in a less time-consuming way. I'd like to add that I'm absolutely no expert, and Marx's work is fairly complex. Lots of it is open to some degree of interpretation and debate. Lots of it is open-ended, pointing towards a line of inquiry or a new set of questions rather than answers. And a lot of it is unfortunately unfinished, or in the case of some of Volume 3, barely readable at all. My explanations on the text throughout this series is based on both my own notes after reading through all three volumes, and the collection of notes I've written after reading a few well-known companion guides, some of which I will link down below. I highly recommend that people that are interested should check them out. They explain things probably much better than I do in these brief videos, and discuss things at a much greater length. However, I will say that absolutely no one is an authority on Marx apart from Marx himself. Without wanting to dive into my personal politics too much, I do feel that Capital is probably one of, if not the greatest piece of work that dissects capitalism, how it functions, how it was formed, and the ramifications of it on the world around us, and how it's still extremely relevant over 150 years later. However, I also realise that they're not the easiest books to read. Altogether, they're 2,600-ish pages, incredibly dense, written in an incredibly outdated and old-fashioned manner, often within the context of historical events that have largely fallen from people's mind or relevance, and sometimes just painfully, painfully dry and repetitive, with stats and figures and prices and linen and coats and linen and coats and linen and coats. My goal is not to discourage people from reading Marx. In fact, it's the opposite. I'd highly recommend people reading him for themselves, trying to understand his work on their own terms, gaining new insights from it, and forming new questions, all of which are very valuable to the future of our anti-capitalist struggle. But I also understand that not everyone has the time available for reading, or even the desire to read such a tome of a book. My goal, again, is to simply break down Marx's three volumes of Capital into the easily digestible chapters, focusing on the important parts, and hopefully presenting them in a way that makes it easy to understand and promote further discussion of our anti-capitalist struggle. An inevitable problem that arises is bias, or a selected reading. If my goal is to make each chapter understandable and engaging in a short video, it's obvious that I'm going to have to decide what I personally think is important to understand within the books and each chapter. I think it's also important to include references and context that are grounded in the present day, just to make them a little more understandable. My aim is not to warp Marx's ideas, but I prefer to be honest and say my reading is not the definitive reading of Marx. This project unfortunately sets limitations, and again, I highly, highly encourage people to read the books for themselves. I'll also point out that while I'll try to keep my personal questions away from the content of the chapter, I will also occasionally post some of my own thoughts and questions at the end of the videos. How to read Capital? This might sound like a strange question. It's a book, you just read it. But when it comes to Marx, I think a lot of people have some preconceptions of what may be in his works. They think of him as a revolutionary, as a communist, expecting to open the pages of Capital and be confronted with revolutionary polemics urging the proletariat to take up arms or overthrowing of the state. And they might quickly become surprised or even disappointed. In fact, there's actually very little mention of alternatives to capitalism or possibilities for dismantling it. There's certainly moments when Marx's thought heads towards those ideas or possibly points in their direction, but the conclusion or analysis of them is often very much left up for you to think about. Even more surprisingly, the famous class struggle that Marx is well known for is barely touched upon throughout the three volumes. It is discussed and holds some significant importance in volume 1, but it's barely mentioned at all in the following volumes, and in my personal opinion, this is something that you should be critical of when reading Capital. It's always worthwhile reflecting on a subject or idea and asking yourself, how would the class struggle change this argument? How would the class struggle change this particular aspect of capitalism? What's important to remember going into the reading is that it's actually written from the point of view of a perfect capitalist system. In Marx's day, when Capital was written, it was the birth and childhood of liberalism and laissez-faire capitalism. The dominant economic writers of the time were people like Adam Smith, David Ricardo, and John Stuart Mill. And within their writings, they all wrote in a very abstract form within the realms of ideas, of a fanciful, perfect free market that would enable all people to be the liberators of their own destiny. And it's on these same terms that Marx also begins his writings within Capital. He meets the dominant economic writers of his time on their own terms, using the same abstracted ideas of a perfect free market capitalist economy, but then firmly rooting it in a materialist history, showing how, time and time again, even this perfectly functioning abstracted ideal of capitalism relies on the exploitation and domination of all involved, and results in crisis after crisis. It's also worth mentioning that Marx saw 19th century England and its history as the perfect backdrop and prime example of a fully formed and developed capitalist system. And it's within English history and economics that Capital takes place. Again, I'd like to stress, and this point will no doubt cause some debate, that these books are told through the point of view of capitalism, not the working class. And there's very little reference to how the working class struggle could interrupt or alter these processes. At no point throughout these books does Marx discuss inevitable economic stages of development on a worldwide scale, only within the context of British or Western European capitalism and its own desire for progress. Marx was keenly aware in his other writings that this development would be different in different parts of the world, and that the working class action can change or even sever this capitalist development process. Hopefully this series helps people gain a better understanding of Marx's work and highlights how the complex system of capitalism dominates our world and our place within it. And hopefully it helps future discussion for our collective anti-capitalist struggles. Thanks for checking it out.